Okay.
Where was I? Estoy en vivo.
¿A dónde estábamos? Que estábamos, we were talking about the
So I was explaining that this perfect amount that the car will roll and dive and squat while driving around the track.
Estábamos hablando de la forma perfecta entre comillas de cuánto el carro tiene que inclinarse hacia un lado o hacia el otro para que se sienta bien.
And I explained how different drivers want it to happen at a different speed. Some like the car to roll to that point really quickly, or dive quickly, squat quickly to make the car very responsive.
Hay pilotos que les gusta que de acuerdo a la velocidad en que vayan responda ese ángulo de inclinación de acuerdo a la velocidad. Hay unos que les gusta más rápido y a otros les gusta que pase más lento. How can you tell Joseph or how can you arrange that point?
So the speed at what that happens, you adjust with the shock oil. So a thicker shock oil will make everything the car does happen a bit slower. So it will roll slower, it will turn into the corner a bit slower. Everything will be more stable and slower.
Okay,
what's up, guys? We're here in Pereira, Colombia.
Oh,
it's a really nice facility. They got a nice off-road track. They got CrossFit over there. BMX track, soccer field, football field, basketball courts.
You
got guys from all over Colombia here, from Medellin, Bogota, Cochabamba, Cali. They've come to this clinic.
Really is to every track doing. Of every traction condition have the car do the same thing. So let's say you're on a very slippery track,
man. This is like in Colombia.
That the car will want to slide.
They got about 7 tracks here. I'm going to go up and show you guys the track in a bit, but let's look a little bit at Joseph's favorite subject, which is roll centers and
el carro no va a rodar, sino que se va a deslizar, y eso es lo que nosotros no queremos, perder tracción.
So to generate more traction on the slippery track and to get the car to roll and feel the same as it did on the trackway was perfect, you can go to thinner sway bars. So a thinner sway bar on the front and the rear will allow the car to roll on a loose track.
Por eso ahí Kenneth utilizamos las barras más delgadas. Si queremos que el carro ruede más y gire más rápido, cambia las barras de adelante y de atrás más delgadas para que el carro no se vaya, sino que ruede más y tenga el ángulo, alcance el ángulo más rápido.
You will have more grip and a more comfortable feeling driving around the track.
Y vas a tener más grip,
yeah,
más
ready for four roll. See you in a couple of days, buddy. Not touching that fireball.
En una pista que sea resbalosa.
And because the track is slippery, when you go into the corner, you slow down. It doesn't slow down as quick. The front doesn't dive. When you accelerate, there's not forward bite, so the rear doesn't squat. So you can change the springs also, again to have the same movement. So softer sway bars, softer springs. The car will roll instead of slide, and it will dive and squat like it's supposed to.
Y ahí podemos ayudar al carro también a tener resortes de suspensión más delgados. Entonces, tienes la barra más delgada, tienes el resorte más delgado, y eso hace que el carro ruede más y se comporte mejor en las curvas cuando una pista está suelta y no hay tracción.
Exacto,
no se deslice.
A high grip track, what happens is you go there again with your same setup, which is very good on your home track.
I'm going to show you guys the track. Seteado, por ejemplo, para esta pista, y van y cambian de pista y se van para una pista
Juan Jose.
Donde hay mucho agarre.
Juan Jose came late. Ahora se acaba.
Entonces el carro lo que va a hacer con ese setup es que va a rodar y agarrar demasiado rápido.
Está ready. Manda saludos a Sudamérica. Alright guys, here we have the track. Here we got CrossFit girls over there. I'm gonna go up in the driver's seat and show you guys real quick. It's a nice little facility here. It's like, we call it the jungle track. Look, it's like jungle over there. They were training BMXer earlier. So got a nice big driver's stand. It's about 5 meters high, I could say. Not too much big jumps, but it's a fast track. Got a double in the straightaway to a weird type of 180. Another double that's actually not very easy to do. got up off camber, turn there like a bank. This section here is really fast. You'll be touching off the pipes and coming by. A 180, another fast section to a small double, another bank turn there. I got back straight away for bigger double. Then there's three jumps over there in the corner to a 180, back around. There's a lot of 180s on this track, but it makes it exciting. They're over there doing CrossFit. Saw some girls like climbing up on pegs, and yeah, it was pretty deep. As you can see, there's the BMX track out there. Let me see if I can go in a little. That's where they start. I really would like to go over there and throw some fat lips, but we aren't allowed over there. Pretty nice. The temperature is really nice. If the sun's out, I'd say about 75 degrees. It's not too hot, it's not too cold. Obviously in the sun, it's a little different, but it's not bad at all. We're about 2,000 meters above sea level, so the motors do lack a little bit of power. We got JQ Columbia. We're growing. I like this guy's starter box. I think it's cool. Hold on, guys. That's pretty cool. He's even got a JQ on his. Yeah, this is just a little bit of guys. They have their nationals next week, so it's in Bogota. So a lot of guys are in here. They're getting ready for the nationals next week. But we did get a good group of guys come here, as you can see. So we do a clinic and then do some wrenching and do some driving. And then I think tomorrow we have a small race.
To the links or the shock position or pistons or Ackerman or all the small changes, anti-squat, towing, they are details to make the car more comfortable for that track.
Todas estas partes que dice cambiar
de
resortes, amortiguadores, ángulos delanteros o traseros, even the altitude, the height of the
right, car, right? Yes, all of those are small details.
También la altura del carro, todo eso son detalles importantes que se tienen que, detalles pequeños o menores, pero que se tienen que hacer gradualmente para que siempre el carro sea consistente.
So you start with the sway bars and the springs for that track to get the car's movements correct.
Primero haces lo de la barra. Después de la barra haces lo de la amortiguación. Después de la amortiguación haces lo de los resortes.
Primero barra, después resortes y aceites.
¿Le puedes verificar esa información?
Can you repeat that part again, please, Joseph?
For any track, low grip to high grip, the first thing you do is you set the sway bars. So thinner on a slippery track, thicker on a...
Lo primero que haces es ver el sway bar. O sea, o subirla, ponerla más gruesa o más delgada, dependiendo de la... Después, el resorte del amortiguador.
And if your car is good, it has a good basic setup, then that's enough to have it. 80% there.
Ahí está, ahí puedes hacer o ganarte el 80% de cómo está el setup del carro.
All the other changes are details to make it more
comfortable. Guys, you're gonna rock four roads, it's gonna be awesome.
Todo lo demás son detalles para hacer el carro, seguir haciendo el carro más confortable y más manejable.
I can explain all of those.
Ahora sí, si no tienes el sway bar, meter las partecitas finales hacia adentro, genera cambio.
Share this video, guys. Let's get more people going. Get more people on here. Yeah, JQ's a little slow today. He needs Red Bull. So what's up, Joseph?
If you don't have the sway bar, for example, if you need a thicker sway bar and you don't have it, what's the difference if you
That's good, Jeremiah. Put the guys ready to rebuild my car. I don't have two cars like some
people. The screw that this way bar holds, you know?
You can make it a bit stiffer.
Exactly. If you move this part forward or backwards, if you have the...
If you move it on this car, for example, on the back backwards, it would make it a bit harder, but I wouldn't do that because it also starts to limit the travel.
What's up, Abby?
No lo haría porque primero, obviamente, lo hace más duro, pero al hacerlo más duro, limita el travel de la suspensión.
It's just one position which is best, and you always do that, and you just change the sway bar.
Solamente hay una posición para esa parte y lo que se hace es cambiar la sway bar. Si no la tiene, pues cómprela, viejo.
Sí, se puede apretar los tornillos de la caja del diferencial. Los tornillitos que le apretó él ahora.
Si los aprieta está limitando la suspensión.
¿Cuáles tornillos?
Los que le apretó él ahí atrás.
Los de la barra.
Esta de acá. Okay, so they're telling how's the difference if you have these two screws loose or if you have them too tight.
I mean, you just need to set it so there's a small amount of play. You don't adjust this. This isn't a set of change.
Eso no se ajusta ni se aprieta, solamente tiene que haber siempre tiene que tener un juego mínimo que tiene que moverse con libertad, pero eso no, ni se aprieta ni queda quieta ni queda suelta totalmente, siempre apretada hasta que tenga un...
Yeah, we're here in Colombia. Share this video. Gonna see my boys Jeff and all the other guys soon here, and Kenny P and all the other guys from Florida, Mike, all coming up to Fall Bro. It's going to be epic. We're going to have a live lit pit. We got one tent so far set up. We need three more tent frames. We're going to have one of the biggest pits at Fall Bro. And yeah, man, let's get a little bit more setup help from Joseph here. We got the guys here in Colombia.
Balance is right when the front is
thinner. Yeah, Kenny, we are.
Afecta el balance. Siempre tiene que ir la más gruesa atrás.
We got some more people watching though. We gotta announce these back.
What happens if you have the same sway bar, for example, this is 2.5 and
you don't have to watch them live.
And you put the 2.5 and in the front.
Yeah, Joseph, you don't have to watch them live.
The stock spring is great.
Run.
And we run this on low traction to medium traction tracks. Here I would run my stock gray spring. Then if I go to a high grip track or a track that's very edgy, the car wants to flip over and grab bumps and it's difficult because of the grip level, then I would go to a harder spring. I like to use the hot bodies yellow, front and rear. That's the only two springs I use. Gray or hot bodies yellow. That's the two different springs I use.
Él usa por lo general al frente los resortes de hot bodies, los amarillos. Y también los hot bodies, los yellow. Why the yellow?
It's a harder spring.
How many pounds of pressure are there?
I don't know. I'm only almost an engineer.
Solamente se rige por el color.
En las diferentes marcas utilizan diferentes colores, pero
you can't compare. The only way to compare is put them on your car and drive on the track.
Lo único que puedes hacer es ponerlo en tu carro y salir a manejar. O sea, in different brands, for example, which if I compare the yellow hot bodies with the, for example, he drives Lossy.
You can't compare. You can have two springs which are same diameter wire, same amount of coils, and they will be different.
Que todos los resortes son diferentes, inclusive si tienes el mismo resorte, el mismo grosor, pero entre marcas cambian y nunca va a ser igual. Así tengas el mismo, las mismas especificaciones.
No, pues no las consigues por las libras, digamos. Claro. Así, las libras.
Pero entonces tienes que ver qué libras, por ejemplo, de yellow. Soportan para el Lossy o para Mugen o para Kyosho, ahí te puedes dar cuenta, pero igual él dice que también de acuerdo a las marcas el número de springs, o sea de vueltas, cambia.
No siempre
van a tener los mismos anillos en los Lossy que en los Mugen, que en los JQ.
Carlos over there, and I don't remember the other guy's name, but he just got a car. I'm hoping we'll have some more. I'm pretty sure we'll have some more JQ drivers after this. Hey, but remember, a TLR used the gray springs in Argentina.
y ya les dice cuál es el setup para esta pista, para la que ustedes quieran.
Actually, in Argentina, TLR drivers run JQ Gray Spring.
En Argentina, todos los pilotos de Lossi usan los
uno, nada más.
No, de JQ.
No, todos.
Oh, okay, now we speak Spanish.
So, sway bars. The standard setup on JQ is 2.3 front, 2.5 rear.
En JQ se usa en el setup, en el básico, 2.3 adelante y 2.5 atrás.
That's a very good compromise for every track.
Ese es un buen inicio para cualquier pista.
For me, I normally always change to a harder rear sway bar. 2.6 instead of 2.5.
You keep the front the same. Él nunca cambia el sway bar delantero. Lo único que hace es cambiar el sway bar trasero, dependiendo si es grueso o delgado, pero nunca toca el del frente.
The reason is that I drive the car more aggressively with more
throttle. We've done a pretty good job on this tour.
And faster than
we also want to promote racing here in Latin America.
I
also want to say good luck to our guys in Costa Rica. They're having their first ever nationals. So
we
have two guys racing the cars there. And
I
believe they just became a member of Farmar. So that's good, man. RC is growing. Here in Colombia, they have 7 tracks. In Medellin, Bogota, Cali, so they race here as well. We just want the rest of the world to know.
Cuando él cambia, por ejemplo, el sway bar trasero a 2.6, lo que hace es que tiene mejor consistencia cuando él va a full acelerador full.
If the track is higher traction, then I go to a 2.8.
Y cuando tiene más tracción, se sube a 2.8. La pista. Cuando la pista tiene más tracción, él sube el sway bar a 2.8, o sea, más gruesa.
So for me, I only really use 2.5, 2.6 and 2.8 on the rear.
Solamente él utiliza o 2.5 o 2.6 o 2.8. Esas son las tres que él siempre utiliza.
Yeah, I'd love to come to a BD contest.
So 90% of the time, I run in Italy,
it looks so much fun.
En el 90% él corre con 2.6.
The track was awesome. The
atmosphere was great.
And normally I start.
Hopefully next year, let's see what happens.
We got some more JQs, man. We got to
take over the world. 2018 is the year of JQ. Of the JQ.
If I want more steering, I'm struggling. For example, on this track, there's many hairpins, and the track is slippery. And then my car just pushes, it doesn't want to turn, then I can go for to a 2.2.
Por ejemplo, en esta pista, él recomienda, como es una pista que es muy suelta, él recomienda que la barra estabilizadora delantera sea de 2.2 para que el carro tenga, alcance el ángulo de inclinación, gire mejor y no se vaya el carro, digamos, derecho, de trompa.
So the thinnest sway bar gives me more steering in hairpin especially.
O sea, va a tener mejor y va a tener mejor dirección.
Off power, so into the corner.
O sea, cuando se está dando la curva en la curva.
If I'm really desperate, then maybe I'll go to a 2.1.
That's Sebastian Beltran, one of the fast guys here in Colombia.
But normally I just
Paolo, he was out with us last night.
Normalmente 2.2 o 2.3 max.
Paolo.
On a high grip track, you can go to a.
You guys went out, had a few drinks.
En una pista con mayor tracción, obviamente uno puede subir las barras a más gruesas.
But for me, normally I don't do it because it also makes the car a bit
more noisy. He wants to do a clinic at Full Bro as well, Jeremiah.
After that,
everybody's invited.
Pero él no lo
not
no
just
lo
JQ guys.
So
whoever wants to do the clinic Friday evening,
no
at Full Bro. He's going to be available. They're going to cost this beer.
Normally 2.2, 2.3,
and we don't have any beer right now, so we need to get some.
So in conclusion, la barra del frente, 2.1, 2.2, máximo 2.3. Y en la parte de atrás, desde 2.5, 2.6, hasta 2.8 máximo.
Still good.
Okay, so the difference, the range of sway bars I use isn't very big, as you notice. So maybe another driver would use the same range but thinner sway bar. So, as I said in the beginning, the changes we make are not very big. So normally, when you make a change, make it one step at a time.
Siempre hay que hacer los cambios, hay que hacerlos progresivos. O sea, como él viene diciendo, o sea, la barra también igual. O sea, si no se siente cómodo, cámbiela a una barra, si quiere más gruesa, pero no cambios tan grandes precisamente para ver el carro cómo se comporta. Igual de la misma forma, tanto adelante como atrás.
Should we do the dips now? It kind of ties into the same.
¿Quieren hablar de diferenciales? ¿O de qué quieren o qué tienen preguntas? No, usted no, güey.
Sorry, shake the camera. I only got one hand.
Es que hay una teoría que es la que todos entendemos que entre la silicona es más baja, obviamente, pues más fácil de tirar el carro cuando la pista está rota y todo eso. Eso está claro. Lo que no está claro es que muchas veces la gente piensa que cuando la silicona es más baja atrás, más delgada, el carro va a tender a sacar menos la cola. Pero muchas veces hay una descompensación, sí, muchas veces subiendo el carro atrás se va a comportar mejor. Entonces, en realidad, ¿qué consiste la teoría de que el carro, digamos, tenga más tracción atrás y no siempre sea bajar la silicona?
Hablemos de diferencia primero.
Sí,
hey guys, want to hear about dips, man.
Pregunta,
the creator for dips here in Colombia.
Blocked from this clinic.
No, I asked about
he's talking about the theory that we have, we've all been hearing about the deep soils, about the thickness. There's the theory, if you have a thicker oil at the rear, the car is more aggressive, but you lose traction.
Here we go. Okay.
I ask a question because I know that sometimes, like a theory that we all have here is if you have a thinner oil, the car will be easier to drive. Rear. But sometimes you have a thinner oil, like the car will be like more like hard to drive because the chemistry between the other two diffs.
The balance. You're losing the balance between the different.
Sometimes going up in rear diff is gonna be greater for the car to have more traction. So how it works?
This is complicated shit. Let me explain, okay?
Pero yo no quiero traducir las malas palabras. I'm not translating your bad words and your bad manners.
Let me explain, okay?
Déjeme explicar, que es algo complicado, pero para que entendamos.
Oh my god, I haven't even started at all.
Hold on! Yes. Let's go to the basics of differentials. So the main concepts, and then we go deeper, and you're gonna be
yes.
Crazy.
Tranquil, everyone.
Maricones.
No can say that. I'm on video. The dips affect the feeling of the car on and off power.
Los diferenciales. Afectan al carro tanto acelerando como sin acelerar.
Standard diffs that come in all the cars with the standard oils that you can see on all the setup sheets are good enough to win a world championship.
Los aceites que dice el catálogo de los diferenciales son suficientes para ganar un mundial de RC.
Yes, changing the oils changes the feeling and maybe you can be faster or maybe you'll be slower or more or less consistent, but it's not magic. There is not one magic setup.
No hay ningún setup de diferenciales que sea pues como el ganador ni que haya, obviamente afecta la aceleración, el comportamiento del carro, pero pues eso depende.
A good driver would probably end up doing the same lap times with all the different setups.
Que un buen corredor no se puede diferenciar por qué diferenciales tenga. Se supone que tiene que ser consistente, como habíamos hablado, que cambia el manejo del carro, pero también lo que le entiendo es que también se adapta el piloto al carro para que el carro se comporte bien.
Lo que él dice es que pues, no tanto la consistencia, sino que cada piloto, digamos, así le cambia la silicona, puede hacer la misma
vuelta. Exacto, cada piloto puede hacer con diferentes siliconas, puede hacer una misma vuelta un tiempo. Bueno en cada vuelta.
Exacto. Nice hats. Get them in a JQ Racing store.
What you are trying to achieve is comfort and an easy car to drive, so you can easily turn your best lap times consistent.
La idea es tener un carro confiable y consistente para tener mejores vueltas y ser consistente.
So that, let's start with the front dip. Actually, let's say something in general.
No, ¿qué nos iba a preguntar? No, básicamente
la diferencia entre
un
lubricante grueso y no.
Ah, okay.
O sea, ¿qué hace uno grueso y qué hace uno
grueso?
Sí, o sea,
the
thinner oil.
Yes. Okay. New rule for Colombia. I'm going to explain the diff right now, and no one's going to interrupt or ask a single question until I'm done.
Que no pregunten hasta que les diga el concepto básico y después ya con mucho gusto.
Capiche,
comprenden, para que entiendan de alguna forma el concepto básico y después él entra en las.
Hard enough as it is.
Es, ya es suficientemente difícil como pues para.
Generally, you can say that on a slippery, difficult, bumpy track, thinner diff oils will be easier to drive.
En una, o sea, lo básico es en una pista que sea resbalosa y con huecos. Hay que poner aceites delgados.
Generally, you can say that on a very hybrid track, thicker diff oils will be easier.
Y en una pista al contrario, con mucha tracción, hay que poner aceites de diferencial mucho más pesados, gruesos para tener alcanzar la mejor tracción.
Generally, you can say if your car is difficult to handle off power. Your dips are too thin.
Si el carro in
any, just if your car is difficult when you let off the power and you're just rolling.
Cuando el carro no está acelerado, o sea, ustedes no están acelerando y ustedes tienen dificultad para controlar el carro, es porque tienen los aceites muy delgados.
Generally, you can say that if your car is difficult to control when you are on power, the dips are too thin.
Okay, entonces deme.
No, no, he wants to hear it again.
Tenemos una regla entonces. The two concepts las dos reglas. Cuando tenemos un carro sin acelerar, ojo, sin acelerar, off power, o sea, sin acelerar, no acceleration, no, o sea, está rolling, o sea, andando. Y es difícil de controlar, los aceites son muy delgados. Cuando el carro está con acelerador, cuando ustedes están acelerando y el carro es difícil de manejar, el carro tiene los aceites de diferenciales muy pesados. O sea, están las dos. ¿Listo? Acelerando, difícil de manejar, aceites de diferencial muy pesados, muy gruesos. Muy grueso. No, y si es difícil de.
Jake is drinking.
No, we have to redo this.
No, I'm gonna explain it fast. Lo que le está diciendo es, si ustedes llegan a una curva, un ejemplo, y entran sin acelerador y el carro está rodando hacia la curva y el carro está difícil de controlar, significa que los diferenciales están muy delgados.
Exacto.
¿Qué pasa? Si cuando ustedes aceleran o van con power, el carro es difícil de controlar, es porque los diferenciales ya son demasiado altos.
Demasiado altos, correcto.
But these are general rules and they don't always apply. That's why it's more complicated.
Es una regla general, pero no siempre aplica.
All separately. So the front diff controls the steering feel the most.
El aceite,
feeling of the steering on and off power.
El aceite del diferencial delantero lo que hace es controlar el doblado, el
sensación,
el cómo se dice,
la dirección.
If your car is very bad, very difficult to drive, it's not feeling good. You can't fix it by changing the front diff.
Es difícil de controlar el carro, no necesariamente cambiando el diferencial delantero van a cambiar el comportamiento del carro.
Maybe if you put mud and stones in the diff, I don't know, but I'm talking about normal diff oils you use. It's not going to be a huge difference that's going to save the day.
O sea, no hay tampoco una regla exacta en donde diga si el carro nos va a acelerar, gracias Carlitos. Si el carro nos va a acelerar mejor o peor en la curva dependiendo del aceite, eso también es la sensación del corredor.
So typically a thinner front diff oil will give you more off-power steering. So on this track, I brake, I turn into the corner. With a thinner diff, I will have more steering.
O sea, en esta pista con un aceite, con un diferencial más bajo, tiende a cruzar más o ayuda a cruzar mejor.
En aceleración.
Sin aceleración, off power. O sea, sin aceleración.
A thicker front diff will do the opposite. So I brake, I turn into the corner, and the car pushes more, less steering into the corner.
Entonces, en esta pista, si tendríamos el diferencial delantero más grueso, más alto, no cruzaría tan rápido, lo que haría el carro sería irse.
But this long corner before the front straight, I will have more steering. It will be easier for me to just get on the throttle and turn, and the car will turn around the corner nicely and accelerate on the straight.
Which one? The
long corner here before the straight.
Ah, por ejemplo, you say thicker?
Thicker.
O sea, por ejemplo, si, pero él pone el caso, si en esta curva de aquí, antes de llegar a los pits, él pondría un aceite de diferencial más grueso precisamente para tener más control del carro, porque el carro se va mucho.
I will also have more acceleration. So before that jump over there, after the straight, I will have more acceleration. It will be easier to do the jump.
Y tendría más aceleración, más poder, entonces sería más fácil de alcanzar el salto, de lograr el salto.
So for me, I like to run the thickest front diff that I can get away with. So I mean, I have the most acceleration. It's easy to drive on bumps, on differing traction, because the front diff makes it stable turning.
What do you run in the front?
I tend to run like 10,000 to 15,000 in the front.
O sea, él está corriendo ahorita entre 10,000 y 15,000 en el diferencial delantero.
My car is a bit different than some others. Maybe in a Kyosho you would run thinner oil.
Tal vez en el Kyosho se pueda bajar el aceite.
Maybe in a Kyosho people run 7 to 10, I run 10 to 15. So in my diffs I can run thicker oils.
O sea, en los diferenciales de JQ se puede correr con unos aceites de diferenciales más gruesos. En los otros carros, por ejemplo el Kyosho, él recomienda, digamos, for this track, 7 or 8? The Kyosho or any track?
This track, yeah, 7 to 10 should be good.
Por ejemplo, en el Kyosho dice que de 7,000 a 10,000 estaría bien para una pista de estas.
We have a rule.
Pregunta.
Write it down.
espérate que todavía no para que no se le vaya la idea. Entonces ahorita ya que anotes la pregunta para que no se te olvide.
Sensitive.
That's why the lousy guys, you know?
Lousy guy.
Así me estaría uno si enamoraba la chat.
Bueno, te voy a decir running with the lousy. No! I was spying for JQ. I was spying for JQ and, you know?
Mamma mia. Sensitive.
Diferencial central.
It's more important than the front.
Es más importante que el diferencial delantero.
If you are very extreme with the diff oil, you can actually make a good car with that.
What do you mean?
You have a good car, you change the center diff oil too much in one direction, it can be difficult.
Puedes tener un carro bien seteado, pero si, por ejemplo, le cambias el aceite del diferencial central, te puede cambiar totalmente. Es tener un carro bueno y consistente, lo puedes ya tener con ese cambio un carro malo y que no sea consistente.
The thicker the center diff, the more acceleration you have.
Entre más grueso el diferencial central, va a tener más aceleración.
Entre más grueso, más aceleración.
The more high grip the track, the easier the car will be to drive typically with a thicker center diff.
Es fácil manejar un en una pista si el aceite está con alto agarre, si es alto el...
¿Cómo
es que se llama la...
We have a rule.
I'm explaining because it doesn't...
Por eso.
¿Qué pasa? Si la pista tiene mucho agarre...
¿Cómo se dice? Agarre. Es que I'm mixing the word grip and agarre.
I need a new translator.
Yeah.
You need another woman's beer.
I need a real beer at this point.
Con una pista con alto agarre, con un aceite diferencial más pesado, es más fácil de manejar.
The reason is that the car will be more flat. It will do less movement, less squatting and everything, because with a thin diff oil, when you accelerate, the front will diff out. The front will start to pull a lot. Let's say you're going a corner, the car dives, you get on the gas suddenly, it will diff out maybe to the rear. The car will be more unstable on a high grip track with a thin center diff.
En una pista con alto agarre, el carro se va a comportar de una manera, o sea, se va a agarrar más, y puede que los ángulos que nos había hablado ahora puede que sean más pronunciados. Entonces, al tener el aceite más denso, el carro obviamente va a tener más tracción y los ángulos se van a incrementar. Entonces es posible que en algún momento sea
No, he didn't say it right. I'm gonna explain something.
It's what he's saying, but he's not saying it right.
Yeah.
Should we switch?
No. No, pero, ¿qué pasa? Que está diciendo, si la silicona de los diferenciales es mucho más alta.
No, estamos hablando del diferencial central.
Eso, el diferencial es mucho más alta.
Sí.
La diferencia entre el de adelante y el de atrás va a ser mucho menor. O sea, no va a tener tanto efecto. Entonces el carro se va a trasladar menos hacia esos diferenciales.
Va a ser más estable, más plano.
Exacto, no se va a llevar tanto hacia adelante.
¿Y qué dije?
Si es muy delgado el diferencial, él sí se va a ir más hacia lo que es el de adelante y el de atrás. Entonces va a tener mucho más.
¿Y qué dije?
Hey, one of them bullets coming for you.
Él lo dijo en pastuso y usted lo dijo.
Also, the thin center diff will be more aggressive steering into the corner on high grip. So high grip, you go into a tight corner, you have more steering. It's harder to drive.
Con el aceite más denso, you have more steering, o sea, tienes más dirección y es más difícil de manejar.
So on the high grip track, the thicker center diff is generally better. But there is a limit. If you go too thick, then it becomes difficult to drive on power.
O sea, pero tiene un límite, porque si tienes ya un aceite mucho más denso, obviamente va a ser más difícil de manejar. On
power. Off power will be easy.
O sea, sin acelerar va a ser fácil, pero con el acelerador obviamente va a ser más difícil de controlar.
The car will be nervous.
Va a estar nervioso el carro cuando
estén acelerando. Nico.
Muy agresivo.
Manda saludos a Nico.
For me, I like to run 10,000 to 20,000 in the center diff.
Joseph corre entre 10,000 y 20,000 en el central. Do you have right now what?
God knows, I can't remember.
No,
10,000-4.
Did we change?
10,000-4.
Yeah, we did change. Yeah.
O sea, en este momento tiene 10,000 y 4,000. O sea, en los diferenciales 10,000, 10,000, 4,000.
I think, let's say, typical basic car like a Kyosho. Many people run too thin oils. They can run thick and get away with it. So I think something like 6,000 to 15,000 probably you can run.
O sea, en el Kyosho pone el mismo ejemplo que se puede correr en el central de 6,000 a 10,000 y no causar pues como el para estar como dentro de los rangos y no volverlo nervioso. Why you explain with Kyosho and not with the...
Just as an example, it's a basic car. Because on my car, I can run thicker oils. Then on a slippery track, let's say here for example, it gets really bumpy.
Por ejemplo aquí que la pista es resbalosa y se hacen huecos.
There are some difficult technical sections on the track.
Que hay secciones técnicas y dificultosas, para que vean.
A thinner center diff will make the car a lot easier to go through the bumps and those difficult sections. Because when you get on the throttle, it won't accelerate as much.
Thinner.
Thinner center diff, easier to drive in the bumps, the slippery sections, because the acceleration is less.
O sea, en esta pista, o sea, el delgado sería más fácil porque es más controlable, básicamente.
And
are you going to change the for example, you're going to run 10,000 here? Va a correr, le estoy preguntando si va a correr con 10,000 en el diferencial central aquí.
The same rule for me applies for the center diff. So the thickest oil you can get away with is the best because you'll have the most acceleration. The car will be the fastest.
O sea, vas a tener más aceleración si lo pones más grueso.
You know that the center default is too thick when you accelerate and the rear feels slippery. So you accelerate, for example, onto the straight and the rear tries to step out. And you feel like the rear doesn't have traction or power.
La forma de saber si tienes el aceite del diferencial muy grueso es que cuando estés en in the straight or the
when you exit the corner.
Cuando la forma de saber si el aceite del diferencial central está muy muy pesado es que cuando está saliendo de la curva el carro la parte de atrás va a comenzar a sacar la cola.
A good example is at the beginning of the back straight. You have the corner with the stones and then you turn the corner on power and accelerate in bumps to the jump. The back corner.
It's up there.
Yes.
O sea, el mejor ejemplo es en la curva de allá antes de la recta de allá del alambrado, que él dice que ahí se ve el perfecto ejemplo.
There, if your center diff is too thick, you get on the power and your rear slides out.
Ahí se ve cuando el aceite del diferencial si está muy denso, automáticamente en esa curva el carro lo que va a hacer es comenzar a colear.
And when you accelerate the bumps, the car will be bouncing around.
Y el carro en los huecos, lo que va a hacer es estar como...
What's up, Tony?
Exacto, como loco, como yendo de un lado para otro.
There, a thin diff will make it so when you accelerate out of the corner, the car will just follow nicely. The rear will have traction and it will be better in those bumps. Not bounce as much.
In the rear.
Ah,
si lo tienes más más delgado en la parte de atrás, lo que va a ser lo contrario.
Okay.
En el central va a ser exactamente lo contrario, va a ser un carro mucho más estable, no se va a mover y saliendo de las curvas va a ser un carro mucho más manejable.
You guys want to go for a track walk?
Okay, really.
Let's go because I think it's going to rain.
Para él el
this is a sandy corner we got here. Coming onto the straightaway. Straightaway has got a jump. They need a little bit of spray some Roundup, but the track's pretty rough, man. And sandy in this area. Their driver's stand is pretty tall. This double's pretty easy. It's got a little hump here that's gonna throw you before you can see it. Nothing too special, pretty easy. And you go down to this weird 180. It's like a 180 with a tit on the side of it. It's pretty cool. This double is a little difficult. You gotta get some speed up. It's pretty rough here. Very rough. But you know this is off-road, so things are gonna be rough. Man, they got some big ants there. Woo. So you jump out there. Oh man, it's gonna rain. You come around to another 180. Up into this off-camber banked turn, I guess. That's pretty cool. This section here is pretty fast. Stay close to the pipes. You can bump off the pipes. Like the opposite on this side. Another easy double. Now this section is a little tricky because it's like the other side of the bank here. It's almost like a jump. You jump over that. I guess you guys want to go listen to JQ babble. I only got 8 viewers. Come around, some tiles on the corner there. A pretty big, I'd say about 25, 30 foot double here. But you can see the takeoff isn't too big.
De la parte de atrás.
batteries. The battery's gonna die. It always dies. CrossFit, look at those big ass tires over there. You do all that stuff, Juan Jose? Yeah. JQ came out here.
I triple it.
Yeah? I'm gonna triple it right into the bamboo. That's my job today. I'm gonna send it over the fence somewhere. I'm sure, but I'm gonna go way into the bamboo.
No, you need to get the car the right way to the job. Like the car in the truck is.
This rough.
It's from there until the left part.
You can see the track rough. How many, what's the lap times like on this track?
My best lap time was on the Nats this year was like 35.8.
That's a nice size track, 35, 36 second track.
But everyone was doing 39, 40.
Okay, well you're fast.
No, I'm not.
But let's go listen to JQ babble for a little bit more, and then his battery is gonna die. Yeah, but people have questions. That's a good idea.
Depende, ahí pues habla más o menos de la relación que tiene el diferencial central.
No.
I'm just trying to explain how, because you said the same theory with the center diff. Pasa lo mismo con el diferencial del centro que con el diferencial trasero. Dependiendo cómo, o sea, cuánto grueso lo tengas, el carro va a responder de una forma.